Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and it's September 19th, 2016, and I'm here at storage unit E59, and it's like 9 a.m., and this isn't Greece. I'm already sweating my balls off here because it's so freaking hot, but I'm trying to clean up the remainder of the crap at the facility, and of course I'll take a few video clips here and there to share with y'all. Yes, I can say y'all, because technically I live in the deep south. Well, here is a really nasty, moldy case from an Apple II Plus. And yeah, this is gonna get trashed. And no, I'm not putting it on eBay, and it's whatever. But here we go, 177 pound Italian. Let's do the weight test. Can I stand on this without it breaking? And yeah, that's pretty damn good, pretty strong material. I could have jumped up and down on it, but come on, I don't wanna do that. You know what? I'm gonna clean and sterilize the top, because you know what I can use this for? It makes a lovely cutting board for the kitchen. Well, this is interesting. First of all, this is not an Apple keyboard. Listen to it. And the power light, it wasn't like clickable. This is like third party. That's definitely not an Apple motherboard. That is absolutely not. It looks like it's a clone. Either that, or it's an early prototype, and I'm throwing out something that's worth millions. But yeah, this is an interesting find. The ROMs are like manually labeled. These must have been burned by a third party. So yeah, this is a cloned Apple II or II Plus your motherboard. There it is, and soon to be tossed. Here is a legitimate Apple II motherboard, which is adorned with the Apple Computer Inc. logo, label on the switching power supply, and yeah, this is a tossed material, but let's just do a quick Star Wars flyby. You can see the slots, and that's something that Wozniak pushed on the architecture of the Apple II. Steve Jobs didn't want that expandability, but Woz pushed for the slots, and that's what really made this machine have such incredible lasting power. But even for the time, this board is a work of engineering art. A shout out to Woz. Quite efficient with regard to the number of chips and how this thing was engineered. Again, for the time, amazing. It still is amazing. It really is. Apple II, nice. Okay, so here's an Apple II Plus. Now this one is a keeper. All right, and you see that's just a light. That's not pressable, and the beautiful Apple II logo. Case is actually in really nice. This machine's in really nice shape, and we see that there's the language card installed, which gives you an extra 16,000 kilobytes of RAM, bringing the machine up to 64K. And this thing has the Super Mod 2, the RF modulator, so you can plug it into your television set. And yeah, this is actually nice. I'm gonna see if this thing works when I get home. Well, here's another one. This one's pretty clean too. Ah, that's the keyboard I like. You hear that one? Actually a great keyboard. And we'll take a look inside. Official Apple your motherboard in there. This one does not have the language card. This one has 48K of RAM, but despite being in storage for over 20 years, this thing is actually in pretty good shape. This motherboard was made in Singapore. Nice. We'll see how those capacitors held up all these years. Here's some promo item from Electronic Arts from like a million years ago, and it contained a couple of golf balls and some tees, and the first time I played golf, I kept on using the tee in the fairway. I had no idea. Hey, it made sense to me. It made the ball a hell of a lot easier to hit. Well, this is interesting. This company, Aztecs, a million years ago, made an enclosure so you can remove your Apple II keyboard and put it in an external enclosure so you can put the keyboard like on your lap. It's a heavy piece of shit. Okay, listen to the sound of this Apple II keyboard. This is a newer one. Kind of has the sound of like the Macintosh type keyboard. Nice keyboard. and heading for the trash. Limbrook High School, 1979. I was the lead in the play Fiddler on the Roof. I played the part of Tevye. Too bad the F-tards spelled my last name wrong. It ends in an I, not an E. But then again, I wasn't part of their thespian group, so I think that was like my F-U. You're not really part of our clique. But yeah, sorry, I got the lead. And before we had Nintendo Game Boy or games that you can play on your mobile device, we had this. There you go. Portable chess set. Mobile gaming at its best. Oh, well, look at this. Look at this photo. This is from 1983. That's me with co-worker Shirley Brown introducing the Lisa system. Oh, man, now this is definitely a keeper. Well, I found some interesting stuff. These are Write Protect stickers. When you wanted a Protect, a 5 1/4 inch floppy from being written to, you would put the sticker over a little cutout hole. It just pushed in a little mechanical device so it would disarm the write operations of the drive. Here are official Apple II Disk II labels for the binder that you would store the disks in. Here are some retro Apple stickers, and here are official Apple 3 1/2 inch floppy drive stickers. But wait, there's more. I've been looking for this item for years, and let me show you first where I found it. It was in my vault bank. I guess that makes sense. It was in my vault bank. This thing is like from my childhood that I kept in storage, this vault bank. But let me show you what was inside. There it is, folks. Steve Jobs' business card, his title, Vice President of Operations. I'm definitely going to frame this bad boy. Oh, there's a good one. There's me crossing the finish line in one of those like 6K fun runs back in like, God knows what year this is, like 1980, 81. I think that's the actual step I took that like started the damage of my knee. There it is. Nice history. Ow, still freaking hurts. Oh, now this is nice. Still sealed. A test drive, a Macintosh, I guess, luggage tag. You know, this was a special program to let people take a Macintosh home for a week or two and give it a try, give it a spin. While a fair amount of people did the test drive, a lot of people brought the machine back and didn't buy it. So, in my opinion, it was a failure. But a piece of history, and they gave it a try. Well, this is only going to resonate with people that lived on Long Island. This is a pin from the retail store Alexander's, where I worked for a brief amount of time. Either that or it's Moonbase Alpha from Space 1999, but either way, it's going in the trash. Well, there's an official Apple 5 1/4 inch disc sleeve. This is, yeah, there it is, the old logo. It's actually quite lovely. All right, a special shout out to Mike Sullivan, Sully Dude, and Dave DeFranco Sr., because only the two of you would identify with this. Here's a bag full of pennies mixed with marbles and Star Trek pellets, all right, from the Star Trek tracer gun. Yeah, I'm going to bring this to the bank, into the change machine, see if I can destroy the machine. Look, this gets an awe. It's a penguin ring. Either that or like it's a Linux ring. I don't know. Did I get that joke right? Yeah, well, this scared the shit out of me. Opened up one of the boxes, found a fucking dead snake. Disgusting. I'm looking at this board based on the number of pins. It's definitely not an Apple II card. I'm assuming this is an old PC CGA, VGA card, I guess. Yeah, let's give it a drop test. That's always good. Yeah, gee, did I get shrapnel in my eye? Probably still works. See, now this is a keeper. This is a clone of the Microsoft Z80 card for the Apple II. This gave you access to an entire library of software and an entire a different operating system. This was really quite amazing, and of course the legitimate Microsoft branded card. It was actually a big seller for Microsoft back in the day. This thing held up well. It was in an anti-static bag. So, yeah, maybe I'll fire this thing up one day. Yeah, sure. And back in the day, before we had digital photography, we used to put, like, the roll of film in, like, a canister like this. Now it just had, like, quarters in it. But, yeah, I'm going to use it to jam up the machine at Publix again with the marbles and the Star Trek pellets. Well, this is something cool from my software development history. This is a program I had written called the Communicator, designed by Prometheus Systems, and that logo was done on the Lisa back in 1983, I guess. That's all Lisa class graphics, Lisa Draw, and the Communicator was a single switch text editor for the Apple II. It was designed to help people that were terminally ill and suffering with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis or Lou Gehrig's disease. So the software is written in Pascal. It was designed for the Apple II, and basically what we did, we would analyze the patient or the user to see where they had mobility, you know, usually like a finger, and a very, very sensitive switch was hooked up to go into the game port on the Apple II, and then the software I wrote would let them tap out messages. So it was a multi-windowed system. It would output text to a speech synthesizer. It was pretty cool. Remember, these people, for all intents and purposes, they couldn't move any part of their body and they couldn't speak. So this allowed them to still communicate with family members and friends. I think I sold the software back in the day for like $2,000 a pop. I think I did about maybe 10 installations of it, and then after that I gave it away for free. These people were terminally ill. But yeah, a little bit of Apple II software development history from my end. Look at that. I even had the product registration page. Okay. And the manual. All right, and this is I guess this looks like it was done probably on the Macintosh. Macintosh or Lisa, whatever. I think this was done on the Mac with Apple's color, not inkjet. What the hell do you call it? The dot matrix, the color dot matrix printer. So yeah, full blown manual and on the back the licensing agreement. Yeah, we were official. You know, back in the day, I had a completely FF class Apple II system. Every freaking slot was filled with a peripherable card. Yes, I said peripherable as a joke. Every peripheral card imaginable was stuffed in my Apple II, 2 Plus, then 2E. But let me show you this. You were the shit if you had one of these. Yeah, a hardware printer buffer. Like, you know, just to spool out those documents to that, you know, matrix printer. If you had this, you were definitely the shit. Okay, so there's still more to go, but it's definitely getting a lot less because this thing used to be filled from bottom all the way to the top with boxes. But, whittling it away a little bit each time. And as such, I'm extremely hot and extremely greasy right now. Well, I guess the grease is normal, but not that many wrinkles. So I'm gonna call this E59 session a wrap. More to come, stay tuned. Now, you would think for the bonus clip, I would clean up and power up one of those Apple IIs. But I say, nay, nay. Whilst editing, I realized how shitty I looked, being all sweaty and greasy out in the sun. I figured I'd just show a quick clip to show you that I can still clean up pretty good.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.